Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel, guys. In today's video, guys, we'll be working here on a Ford Focus. And if your AC compressor, okay, air conditioner doesn't work, guys, we'll explain what are the top 5 reasons for the AC not to work and your car not to be blowing cold air. Make sure you stay until the end, guys. We'll share top 5 reasons. It could be more than that, but those are the most common ones. We'll guys have more than 200 videos on every car we get at the shop, including Ford Focus as well, guys. So please subscribe to the channel and like the video. We do all that so we can save you money. Let me show you guys what we'll be doing now. First thing, okay, we'll have the hood open. Doesn't matter, guys, which engine you have. First, we're going to check if the system has enough pressure. So we need to find a low pressure port, which is located back there. Okay, we are going to go ahead and remove the cap. Okay, perfect. And now, guys, we're going to connect, okay, this is a refill bottle with the gauge. You can find where we got ours from in the description of the video below. This is one of the coldest kits on the market that we've tested so far. Okay, and you can see, guys, we do have enough pressure. Check it out. Ours. Okay, it's in the red. So that's enough pressure now, guys. Okay. That tells us we have pressure, so the AC should be working, guys. What I'll recommend to start the car, turn the AC on and check your pressure. And let me show you what will happen quick, okay? Let me do that so you know what to expect. I'll go inside, okay, start the car quick, and then we're going to get the scanner, the diagnostic tool, and I'm going to explain a few things what to look for. Okay, AC is on. So let me show you now. If you come here, what's going to happen? Okay, our pressure, guys, dropped. Okay, but you can see we do have pressure, so that's a good thing. Now, if you don't have pressure, if it's in the low, it may not activate the compressor, so it needs to be in the green, guys, otherwise AC will not work. So far, guys, reason number one, not having enough Freon, which you can check if you have Freon by checking the pressure. Let me turn the car off and I'm going to explain what else you can look for, guys. Okay, what to expect and how we're going to test the other components now. Not very complicated, guys. So, reason number two, guys, it could be AC clutch. Okay, AC clutch, okay, is on the compressor, on the bottom side of the engine, it's on the oil pan. It's a weird location for that AC compressor. But what we'll do, we'll start the car and we'll turn the AC on and off. And you will be able, guys, to hear a clicking, okay, from the compressor now. So listen, if you don't hear that compressor engaging, then, guys, something's wrong. Okay, let's turn it off. On. You hear that click? Off. Okay, let's go again. On. Off. On. Okay, that clicking, guys, is the compressor engaging. And I can see through that hole, never ever stick your fingers, I can see the compressor engaging. It's the very last pulley on the bottom, guys. So, compressor, guys, check the compressor clutch if it's engaging. Now, what could be reason number three, guys? Reason number three, if your radiator fan doesn't work, okay, what will happen? Actually, it will deactivate, the car will deactivate your AC compressor, that way you will not overheat the car. And the fan, you need to check the fan module, you need to check fuse and relays for the fan as well. So that's very common, guys. Now, if your AC compressor doesn't work, okay, you need to check. This is reason number four, guys, your AC clutch, AC compressor clutch fuse and relay. We have the videos on the channel, check it out if you need to do that. And reason number five, guys, but make sure you stay with us, I'm going to show you a few things with the computer, is, okay, that sensor back there on the AC line, on the tin line, this is known as pressure sensor switch, guys, AC pressure switch. What it does, it detects if you have enough pressure in the system to activate the compressor. Now, if it's not working, guys, if it's not detecting that you have the pressure we have, it's going to tell the computer that, okay, we don't have enough Freon, we will not turn the compressor on. And that will result in compressor not working, guys. So let me show you, okay, what I'll be doing here now. I'll turn the ignition on, okay, and we'll be using that computer here now by Maxicom, guys. Okay, this amazing scanner. It works on any car. Okay, it's not just Ford Focus. See how many makes and models that thing supports. It's amazing. You can find the link in the description of the video below, guys. Very powerful little computer that you can do so much with it. So what I usually click, auto detect, then it select Ford USA in our case. This is a American model. And now we are going to confirm the VIN number, okay. And after that, guys, we're just waiting for it, okay, to finish. So, establishing communication. It's decoding and all that stuff. So let me show you what we'll be doing. It says Ford Focus, gasoline, direct injection. We select yes. And now, guys, okay, it's just a matter of time to wait for the for connecting to the car computers. So it should be any time now, guys. Sometimes it takes a little bit longer. Okay, perfect. We select control unit. And now, guys, we're going to select PCM. PCM stands for powertrain control module. So like this, and we're, guys, going to click live data. It's going to load everything here, and we'll be able to check a few critical things that can tell us if the pressure switch is working, if the compressor is working, and all that stuff. As I said, those are the top 5 reasons, but I'll share something else with you too. Okay, once it loads, we will be able to check, guys, if that switch here works as well, because sometimes that switch may not send the signal that okay, it's communicating. So the AC compressor is off now. Okay, check it out, completely off. Now, right here what it says, no fault, AC pressure sensor, it's a 930 kPa, that's the pressure unit. You can change it to PSI if you want. Okay, that's in the settings of the computer, depending on in which region you live, which country. But definitely, guys, there is some good pressure there. And what I will do now, okay, it says AC no fault, we're going to click, okay, turn the fan on, otherwise you cannot turn the AC. Do you hear that click? Okay, and now check out the pressure that it's building even more, and it's detecting it, guys, because that switch is working. Now I'm going to scroll down and it will say air conditioning request yes and air conditioning compressor on. So if I click to turn those things off, here you say compressor is off and the request signal is no. So if you turn the switch on and here it says yes, it means your switch is working. If it says no, it's not working. When I turn it back on, check it out, everything, guys, okay, is working. So those are, guys, the top reasons. Hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you guys having some kind of problem like that. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.